Street.
I see trees of green.
Lady's got rats in her drains.
Oh, there's a rat there.
You've got a problem.
I see them blue.
Be careful where you tread because of the needles in there.
For me and you. And I think to myself.
The undertakers have removed the body now.
What a wonderful world.
September in North London, and the scaffolders have arrived at Edmund Trebus's house. Mike Cording of Haringey Council has declared the place a public health hazard. Over 30 years, Mr. Trebus has filled house and garden with rubbish. After months of wrangling, the council has finally moved in. But so far, Mr. Trebus hasn't come out.
With all the noise that's gone on, it might have attracted him, but not at the moment. But I dare say we'll have an appearance fairly soon.
Mr. Trebus emerges to collect his daily water supply, unaware of what's going on.
I think he's on his way.
Why did you come?
You know why, Mr. Trebus. Let me give you a hand to get down.
No, it's not your property.
I know it's not my property, Mr. Trebus.
So, keep away from me. You don't take the care of my health. Look, I don't need any help from you.
Okay.
I'd sooner drop dead. You came to rob... Look, take that off!
We can't, Mr.
Take that off, I said!
They're building a platform to load the lorry
up. You haven't got any access. You are trespassing. Do you
hear? We've got a warrant to enter and clear.
You haven't got a warrant. Show me that warrant.
I'll show you, Mr. Trebus.
From the police office, police warrant,
yes.
Magistrate, stick it up your chopper. Robbers and murderers. Get it down.
I'm sorry, I can't take it down, Mr. Trebus.
No. Get out of my property, at once.
Get up,
okay.
Mr. Trebus!
Look!
Mr. Trebus!
Go to hell!
Mr. Trebus, there's a court warrant.
Magistrate's court, stick it up your chopper.
It doesn't matter who...
Go away.
Mr. Trebus!
Go away!
Mr. Trebus!
Go away! Go away from my property!
I'll have to...
You are trespassing! Get out of my property!
I've got a magistrate's warrant there. If you don't let us carry on with our work, I'm going to have to
call
the police.
No, I'm not going to... Let you carry on.
Can we carry on with our work, please?
No!
Okay. I'll find the police.
Mike thought he'd seen it all, but he's never had anything quite like this to deal with. Even so, he wouldn't swap jobs with John Waller and Paul Coombs.
What, enter up?
Environmental health workers with a very different job.
I left school at 15. I didn't really have any intentions of getting into this sort of work. There's this little chart on the wall, and it had 0.0001% of school leavers went into this sort of work. So I thought, well, that's a job for me, because if nobody else is going into it, I might get a look in there.
Good morning, Horsey Mortuary!
Paul and John are technicians at Haringey's public mortuary.
There was depigmentation of the substantia nigra.
It's post-mortem day, and pathologist Vesna Jurevic is in full swing.
We do 900 cases a year, so, you know, that's everything from kiddies to old people, accidents, suicides, murders, just deal with everything.
Yeah, cross-section of the community, I suppose, really, when you look at it. You get it on a Saturday. Saturdays you get a lot of fights, but, you know, a few murders. But it's been a bit quiet over the last couple of years, so thank God we're there. I think it's all South London and they're having all the trouble now, aren't they?
Bodies are brought in for post-mortems whenever the cause of death is unknown. Paul and John handle up to a dozen corpses a day, and many of them are a far from pretty sight.
There was decomposition of the soft tissues of the neck, which showed no evidence of significant deep bruising. The laryngeal cartilages, hyoid bone and cervical spine were intact. Brain not weighed, right lung 340, left lung 340, heart 300, liver 1000, spleen 200, right kidney 120, left kidney 120, and then the remarks toxicological examination is being performed. Okay.
This is a poor inner-city borough, and this is a public mortuary in that borough, so it doesn't get much more frontline than this, really.
Except at Mr. Trebus's house.
Could you try and get PC Broom, because she knows all about this case?
Where Mike Cording is calling for reinforcements.
Take that down.
Can't, Mr. Trebus.
Take that down, I said.
All right. Okie doke, thanks a lot. Could be 3/4 of an hour. Mr. Trebus. Mr. Trebus.
I don't want to talk to you.
Mr. Trebus.
Look, that's my property. Don't
you understand? I know it's your property.
So back it off.
I don't dispute it's your property. Would you please have the courtesy just to let me speak? Mr. Trebus.
Oh, shut up.
For just over the last year, I've been trying to persuade you, ask for your cooperation, so we could provide you with better living conditions. You don't want to know. You refuse to cooperate. You keep accumulating rubbish, which is festering away, smelling to high heaven, causing not only a nuisance, but it's now prejudicial to health.
And precisely what horrors lie buried in Mr. Trebus's garden won't be revealed until the clear-up gets underway. Whenever that may be.
Start dismantling it.
Go for
well, I'll start with it, and then that might cause you bigger problems.
No, it will cause yourself problems, Mr. Trebus, if you try and dismantle it, because it's not your property.
Handling awkward customers is all part of the job for Haringey's environmental health officers. More than 250,000 people live in the borough. But it's not just humans who cause trouble. Today, pest officers, George Wardley and Alf Nichols, have been called to deal with a seasonal problem.
Good afternoon, Health Department about the wasps.
Yes.
Come in.
You've
all
got
right.
A heck of a lot of wasps.
Have you?
Oh, what? They're going in where the overflow is. They come in of an evening.
Busy working?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. And it's very bad up there. I know it is.
They're coming through the overflow pipe, which is here. Right, and they're going right along there, and there's the whole nest there.
Is it a big nest, George?
It's lovely. Let's give them a blast first, see.
It's a big one, yeah?
Here they come. I've got a pyrethrum on. It's a quick knockdown. It's the only thing that kills them straight away. Wait till you go outside. You're going to see some wasps out there.
Are you going to bring the nest down, George, or not?
Yeah, if we take the roof off.
Lovely job.
Huh? Best one of the day.
Credit to the lads. Credit.
In Tottenham, food inspectors Bossela Joseph and Dave Taylor are on their way to a Vietnamese restaurant. They won't be stopping for lunch.
A few weeks ago, a customer saw a mouse run across the floor. There were mice droppings everywhere. The place was filthy. That's it all in a nutshell. And obviously, people who go to a restaurant don't expect for food prepared from a place as filthy as that. But if that's their wheeler bin, why don't they put the rubbish in the wheeler bin? Just look at all the oil.
Yeah. I hate wasps. I've been stung by one before.
Somebody's been tossing fat down the drain. This is a road drain.
It's actually hardened up now. So you can actually see the layer.
Layer of congealed fat on the top.
Yeah, you can.
How many people do you have working here?
Four.
Just those two?
The inspectors have powers to rival the police. If they're not happy, they can close a place on the spot.
There's droppings here. There's great difficulty in differentiating between the filth and any other droppings that might be there. This is filthy.
When that falls over, everything falls over.
Do you speak English?
Small.
Small, small. You need to use your energy.
Yeah.
And scrub better.
Yeah.
flies on food, not good. The flies have been in the drain, they've been outside, they've been on dog poo, everything. If it goes on the food, you cook the food, people eat it, they're going to have an upset tummy. So you keep the door shut. Okay? Don't say okay, because if I come back and I see the door open, I won't be very happy. You understand me?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Between wasp calls, George has a few minutes to relax in his back garden, among his beloved hanging baskets.
Are they doing well? Looking well this year. It's nice to come out in the garden and unwind. Sit out there for a while. No, you're not in driving around Tottenham. It just gives you a break, really. Away from the traffic and the noise. I'm proud of my hanging baskets and my fish pond. I like that. I like to come home and see them. When you start to feed and they know you're around, they come up in a minute. Don't ring up and complain about me. But yeah, they're easy to deal with. They don't answer you back. And they don't lie. The sound of the water makes me want to go to the loo in a minute. Yeah, it's nice to sit out and listen to the noise.
Where do you get your carrots from? I'm not going to let me use those.
At the Saigon, Bossola and Dave are not impressed.
Cardboard in the bottom, which is covered in mould, as you can see here. It's not been cleaned for ages, it's falling apart. It's not satisfactory for the storage of food. So we'll have to get rid of that. This isn't very good either, is it? And then you can see, you got moths in here as well.
If I was the owner of this shop, the first thing I would do is to get a broom and clean up the droppings and wipe the whole place down. But you just leave them there. I'm not happy with this place at all. But please, try and improve.
Yes.
I'll come back and see you next week.
Yeah, I will.
I don't want to see a single dropping, okay? This is the last time. Okay. All right, then. Oh! About
Bossola has over 200 food establishments on her patch, and this is far from the worst. Having promised to make amends, the Saigon gets one last chance.
I'm not out to destroy a man's business. All I'm out to do is to prevent people from suffering from food poisoning. Hopefully, we'll get something out of it, but I believe he'll do it.
Mr. Trebus may be 81 years old, but he can still defend himself, taking the law and the scaffolding into his own hands. Mike can only marvel at his determination.
Did you do them up very tight?
Yeah.
Good. Until the police come, I can't do a bloody thing, because he's... Yeah, because he's... If they're not... What time do I ring him? About 9:45? Mr. Trebus, you say I'm not interested in your well-being. I'm very concerned that you're perched up on a scaffold. There's one coming.
The police are on their way, but to a Polish war veteran who survived a German concentration camp, they're little more than a minor irritation.
Hi there. Not so bad.
What have we actually got?
Right, the scaffold is, we're building a platform because the lorry that's going to clear it is going to have sides virtually the height of those scaffold tubes there, so they need to, access to the lorry, and he's basically, within the last 5 minutes, climbed up there and slowly dismantling it.
Right. I don't need a copy of that at all. It's your warrant, not mine.
OK.
Mr. Trebus, you say?
Trebus, Trebus.
First.
Yeah.
Can you come down and speak to me for a little bit, please?
No.
Please come down and speak to me.
Who are you representing? Local?
I'm from the local police station.
Local police.
So I've come to speak to you.
I had enough of you.
Right.
You knocked out my
I can't hear
door.
You, Mr. Trebus.
I'm not coming down.
Mr. Trevis, what you're doing that is dangerous because that could well collapse.
That's my business. What? Not yours.
His own doctor has been to the premises here. The district community physician's been to the premises here, and they both said that he shouldn't be living in this house. He should be in a more, you know, secure accommodation.
Please come down, Mr. Trevis.
But because the Act doesn't provide for taking him out without his permission, unless he's mental. If they're mental, you can just. But as I say, he's been psychiatrically assessed, and they said we can't section him.
Well, yeah,
he's taking it apart.
He's just going to throw it out. He'll have to take it off him anyway.
I'm wasting my time with you.
Well, what I'm going to say to you is what I consider you're doing at the moment is dangerous. Yeah? Please
okay,
stop. Yeah? Otherwise.
That's only endangering my life.
Okay, Mr. Trevis, I'm leaving for a moment. Can I ask you all to back away from this scaffolding? Because I now consider this is going to start getting dangerous. Can we move right back?
It's not too heavy.
Morning, boys.
Morning.
Back at the mortuary, more bodies are arriving for post-mortem. Officially, John and Paul are known as anatomical pathology technicians.
He's got a ring around his toe.
But to their mates, they'll always be the slab boys.
There's not much space in between each shelf, so we're not looking forward to our first Viagra overdose coming in.
In paragraph, there was a yellow metal band ring on the left little finger and fourth left toe.
I mean, if people really ask me what I do, then I'll tell them. But it's not because I'm ashamed or anything like that. It's just because I can't spend the time explaining what I do. And then people just say, I bet you've seen some sights, haven't you? You know, and, oh, no, don't tell me, don't tell me. What do you, oh, no, don't tell me, you know, and all that sort of thing.
We all got to die, haven't we? When we like, there's no way... Can we dodge it? Now, how much money you got in the bank, you're going to die. But at the end of the day, is that I suppose people just want to find out when the door opens and they go through it, you know, what's it going to be like?
Hello, dear. Haringey Council, do you wasps?
George and Alf are back on their rounds in Tottenham.
I can't understand you much.
I've come to do your wasps.
Look, I don't think I've got wasps. I think it's number 25.
No, you've got them. Look, look. Come here and I'll show you. Look, see them?
Oh, yes. I see.
All right?
Oh, sorry.
That's all right. I'm going to go and get some stuff and do it. So stay indoors now.
Yeah,
all right. Last year, the wasps were really quiet, nothing. This year, it's really getting hectic, so we've got to try and catch up with the backlog.
We've got a wasp, there's that. We've got a wasp nest. It's been reported.
Where?
Between the 30 and 31 at the back.
All right, go down there. I'll do that and I'll come down and see you. Yeah? Just spend all day in, you watch.
Yeah.
The idea is to get it onto one of the workers. The worker goes in and gives it to the queen, kills the queen.
Yeah, look at that one there, look. It's all over him, look.
The workers get covered. And they're flapping around and they give it to the queen, that kills the queen off and that's the end of them.
No one of your baskets, John.
No one of my baskets. All right, where is it, dear?
Been here.
This one's brilliant. Is that yours?
Needs a bit of watering, but it's okay.
If she comes back, we should tell her to be careful when she goes in the house.
Next door. I think she should be there.
That one, this one here.
Oh, I don't know her.
All right, if you see her though, just tell her to be careful when she goes in.
Why?
Huh?
Tell her to be careful when she goes in. Well, I'm going out to lunch soon, so...
Oh, all right, go out to lunch, don't matter, I'll tell her.
I don't even know the woman.
That's all right.
Is it?
Yeah, we'll sort it out.
They'll sort it out, they said.
I like the old people better, don't I? More polite.
You've got to be a bit like social services with them as well, you know, like, you've got to listen to what they say to you and agree with them. Keep them happy. Like my mother-in-law.
You go and see a solicitor.
Mr. Trevis has been talked down from the scaffolding, but still won't let the work resume. The council may well improve the property, but they'll charge his estate over £30,000 for the privilege.
Go and do that.
Did you finish?
Mm-hmm. I don't want him arrested.
You're the enemy.
I'm the enemy, yeah. I'm the enemy.
I see my sergeant could be a friend.
Hopefully.
I can appreciate it's your home, and you've lived here all this time, and it must be very, very upsetting. Okay? He wants to involve you in this. He wants you to help him. He wants to actually... They're not just going to take everything away and throw it away. They want to go through it, and he'll go through it with you there so you don't lose anything that is important to you.
Inside the house is dozens of hoovers, washing machines, fridges, old record players, furniture. He's basically got no water supply. He brings in bottled water. We know for a fact he's using the garden as a toilet. You know, you go up the back and the stink is... Well, he won't have it, but he's obviously used to it. But you go up the back and around where... Because he can't get in through the front, he has to...
I'll take your word for that at the back.
I wouldn't go up there, it's not very pleasant.
You make me feel so young. You make me feel so spring has sprung.
Number 10's got one. And every
time I see... You're joking.
No, number 10. He said they're falling in his sink and falling in his bath.
The moment that you speak.
It's not their fault, bloody wasps.
Is it the council's fault, is it? Did the council put them in there?
That's it, yeah.
Yeah? Get in there.
You get in there.
Don't have another fag.
You and I are just like a couple of times.
Still walking around like that, Alf?
Yeah, we're going to go up and do number 10, aren't we?
Picking up lots of forget-me-nots.
Yeah, hurry up here.
Got the last one, ain't ya?
Yeah. What a lovely pair of legs.
They're going in there.
Okay.
Up there. You go behind that bulb there, see? Look.
I don't make it or tell of this.
You'll have to go in there, because you're going to get stung otherwise.
Right.
Have you got a washing dish, love? Yeah.
I think the women outlive you anyway, you know that. Because if you look all around here...
All down here, there's one old woman, isn't it? There's one old boy there.
No, there's two or three old men round here. But most of the men go by about 65, 70, they're gone.
Yeah, just about time to retire.
The women are still going to about 80. It's got more rabbit.
You make me feel so young. You make me feel so young. You make me feel so young. Ooh, you make me feel so young.
It's been a long day at the mortuary. With the post-mortems over, the slab boys are cleaning up the place, in case anybody else drops in.
John the Baptist, they call it. John the Baptist. What's water everywhere, then, isn't it?
Thank you very much for your help. See you Friday.
These are some of our heavy duty instruments.
What are they for?
Don't ask. One in legs. I'm going to carry on. So, see you later.
Whatever, sorry, man.
Table for one, please.
Thank you.
Obviously, people find their humour a bit much to take sometimes. It's a bit like gallows humour. But you've got to keep a sense of perspective. When you come in, all you're dealing with is their bodies all day long. And everybody's got a sad story to tell, you know. So you try not to get caught up in it. And you just deal with the cases as and when they come up.
A week after her last visit, Bossela is back at the Saigon, hoping the owner has done enough to avoid closure, prosecution, and a pile of paperwork.
Ah, they've done it! They've done the fly screen! Hello! You've done the fly screen! Good! That is brilliant! Good on you! Good, cover the door! I'm really happy about that. Really, really happy. Really, really happy. Good. I'm glad, that's a good sign.
So you've been working very hard?
Yeah, so I've been working.
Let me put my coat on. That's good. Yeah, that's good.
Yeah.
Why didn't you use this in the first place?
This one?
Yeah, you could have used that in the first. Let me put my coat on. You can see me smiling now.
All right.
Let me just quickly go upstairs. That is good.
Doesn't it look better for you?
Yeah, of course it's better, yeah.
You've actually done it all. That is good. Oh, you've still got a fly there. You just make sure he stays out.
Okay.
So what are you going to do now? You're going to keep it like this all the time?
Of course
you're
going to keep it all the time.
You know, you gave me so many headaches.
Yeah.
I thought I was going to have a heart attack coming here today. Okay.
Okay, then.
Thank you. I'm happy. You won't see me for a long time. 6 months is a long time.
I will be missed you then.
Would you? I don't believe that. Any time you saw me coming, here comes this terror woman again.
Ossola will be keeping a close eye on the restaurant to make sure standards don't slip.
Okay.
Yeah, all right.
Thanks.
Mr. Trebus has called in his solicitor. Everyone's patience is wearing thin, but there might yet be a way to break the stalemate.
He's such an interesting guy.
Part of the Polish regiment in the Second World War, up through Italy.
See, I think if you could put a front door on
it,
I think he will cooperate to some extent with helping with the removal of the stuff at the back and the side.
If it's all hinges on the front door, I will, even if I put it on myself. Mr. Trebus, if this all hinges on a front door, I'll see what I can arrange to get a front door put on for you.
Once I've got the front door safe, then you realise there won't be any more danger of burglars.
They can put a new front door, but you've got to cooperate with moving of the rubbish at the side. Okay?
No, not till I feel safe.
Mr. Trebus, do you agree to that course of action?
Yes, the front door.
Yeah, and then once that's done, they'll start clearing the rubbish out. Do you agree to that?
No. I'm going to clear myself. No. I don't want... My deeds won't be charged. I do it for nothing.
I know my sergeant has been talking to you at great length. I think we've discussed enough. If the environmental health officer wants to actually execute the warrant and go in, if you prevent him from doing so, you'll be arrested.
Look, why don't you suspend the blooming Haringey... What's his name? Environmental office, including the local police.
I thought we were getting somewhere, but
I don't.
I'd like to get those back on site to erect the platform.
No, they are not going to take the rubbish out. Stop doing
Mr.
that.
Trebus.
Stop doing that.
Okay, Mr. Trebus.
Yeah.
Look.
Come on in.
I got to look. Not use the old bending, breaking my finger. Look,
come on,
sir.
Come on,
and after being charged with a breach of the peace, Mr. Trebus will spend a night in the cells.
I thought I was going to be able to talk him into it, because he talked to me earlier, but he now distrusts me again. So.
He's lost his confidence.
This time, the council are taking no chances. The welders have arrived to make sure Mr. Trebus can't undo the scaffolding a second time.
Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful
world. I just hope he hasn't got an angle grinder, because if he has, when we come back tomorrow, this will all be on the ground. I'm just keeping my fingers crossed.